What they say, cause your matter. Now in my country, carry for my head. Every night, now you are one it. No, 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 don't tell me no, no, no. You can be my partner, never ride it solo, no. And we got lucky, no need to. I'm feeling what you're doing, no, yeah, baby, gotta go. Gotta go, no, no, no. Your body, they make I see you, no. Now you where they got my fancy. Don't they do me, I keep fancy. Oh, no, 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 no.
Should I be early in the morning? Oh yeah, shake it, make it send my money. Call me Mr. Bean, I go make you. Hey, give me, baby, make you give me. I go show you love and I go take you to my city, city. Don't need nothing, make I look pretty. You won't make a sing to roll me before you go see me. See me, fine girl, you know your body bad. Same body bad, can make you for Ghana. Here, here, dancing for me, baby, Ghana. Come and give me show.
Quote, nothing. You want to have a clear mind, a free consciousness, and just let it fly. When you go with the flow, you're in rhythm, and you're not really thinking about it, that's when it feels the best. Brian?
It's a thing of beauty, Allie. Thank you. And let's take a look now at some numbers for Jaylen Brown.
And he's gone cold over the last 10 games, guys. His scoring numbers are down, and he can't seem to get out of this rough patch. He's got to get himself going tonight, or they'll start losing patience with him.
All right, checking out Golden State's opening lineup. The core of the dynasty all on the floor. Curry and Klay, the guards, with Draymond up front at the four. Andrew Wiggins is out there with Kevon Looney. And for Boston, Smart and White make up the backcourt. The core of this team, Brown and Tatum, they're the forwards. And it's Horford in at the five.
And with their title last season, the Warriors now with seven in franchise history. No longer tied with the Bulls. They are alone and ranked third all time.
And so off the tip, it's Boston. Here's Tatum. Let's it go from the baseline and nails it.
Love watching Tatum shoot with decisiveness. He feels like no one can guard him.
And the Warriors still have a long way to go to surpass the Celtics and the Lakers for total championships, each with 17.
But their ambition from the top down is to do exactly that. They want to be, in their own words, the greatest organization on earth.
Definitely playing the long game.
That's a blue-collar bucket right there. Grown man basket. Put it in the work. Got a second chance to score.
Fires in the triple.
He's consistent from out there, especially when you give him that kind of room.
Curry against Smart. From deep. That shot off. And Boston going the other way now. Here's Tatum. Offensive rebound, Celtics. Here's Horford. And finally, they hit one.
Yeah, after all these years as a pro, Horford still plays with fire. Some second chance points there for Big Al.
Curry with it. Impressive numbers he's putting up, averaging just over 28 points a game. Here's Brown. Count it. One for one to start the game.
You've got to appreciate the consistency. Night in and night out, he brings it.
Just over a minute and a half in. And here's Curry. Pass to Thompson. Here's Looney. Now Curry. Will it go? And it's Jason Tatum with a rebound.
And this is exactly who you want taking that shot. You just missed it.
Oh, Tatum slams it home.
Oh, this is how aggressive Tatum is. Excellent job of getting to the rim and a finish. Just light work.
Now Curry. Now Green. And it's hammered home by Green.
What an aggressive move to the rim. He's really trying to fire up his teammates right now.
Boy, it's not hard to feel inspired after a teammate makes that kind of finish.
And that could be the spark they needed to make a little run as they try to even this thing up.
Slams it down with two hands.
Man, they're really getting aggressive now. And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes play. On the wing, Thompson. The three is up. Hits the trifecta.
What poise from Thompson, not allowing for any distractions from his shot.
Here's Tatum. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
Raymond Green.
Jason Tatum, still so young. His game's still evolving. Over the last couple years, he's been getting to the line more and more, and that's huge.
Tatum at the line for two.
And that one falls for Tatum. And Jason Tatum seeing his free throw attempts increase. What's that tell you, Richard?
Well, it just tells me that he's playing with more intensity, but he's also playing smarter. Jason's using his athleticism to force the issue. Get to the easy points at the line. That's what your thoughts are.
And so Tatum nails both of them.
No surprise there. He's about as automatic as it gets from the stripe. I hope I didn't jinx him.
Pass to Green. The three is up. Hauled in by Brown.
And sometimes on defense, you can just get lucky.
And he wills that one in. Sinking it right through the back of the iron. Brown's got six.
The big story thus far, how well they've shot the rock.
Here's Curry. Basket counts.
And you're asking for trouble when you give Curry this positioning. He's so efficient down there.
Here's Brown. Using his post moves to get the 2 points. Give him 8 points now.
Ooh, he's piping hot. 4 for 4 from the field. No one can guard him out there.
Pass to Looney. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. That one on Tatum. And a little deeper into the season now, the depth of some teams already being tested for Golden
State. Yeah, there's a lot of injuries popping up right now. It's tough to establish a rhythm when the guys are being shuffled in and out of the lineup. And truly, to power through, you just need strong leadership.
Can't get the first one.
And you have to think that one advantage this Celtics team has is a deep roster. Lots of quality guys they can assemble different ways. They're pretty adaptable.
Good on the second one. You know, a versatile bench really is a gift for the Celtics in tough situations.
And even a great starting five isn't perfect against every opponent. It's important to have flexibility, and that's something that Boston definitely has. They played with fantastic energy from the opening tip.
Yeah, they're in control on both ends of the court, and it's always impressive when you build a double-digit lead in the first quarter.
Now here's Wiggins. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Six to shoot. Pass to Green. Takes the three. And the Warriors miss again. Green's gone. 1 for 3 from the field here. There's Tatum with the three. Oh, he nails that one. 3 for 4 now.
This has been just a dreadful start for them defensively. Not good at all.
And the Warriors call time here.
Golden State.
This chance to show you the scoring leaders from the last 10 days of action. Jason Tatum, fourth.
He's been on an absolute tear offensively. He's found something that's working for him, and he's sticking to it.
The Warriors have gone 4 of 9 in this one so far. Horford against Looney. Pass to Wiggins. Looney, the screen. Shot is up. And he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in. Boston has gone 2 of 2 at the perimeter. And here's Brown for three. Offensive rebound, second chance shot, and Tatum lays it up and in. Tatum's got 11 points.
And he's carried them this quarter, a dominant offensive stretch.
Now here's Curry. We saw him with 29 points in his last game. He drops it from range.
Let me just say this, Klay Thompson is one of about 10 people in NBA history that you do not want to leave open for a three. The defense has to make it harder for him out there. And he has flat out taken over this quarter. Keep feeding the beast.
Pass to Looney. To the paint. Here's Green. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Curry.
Good luck against Green inside. Even when you throw contact at him, he just fights twice as hard.
Tatum from long range. He can't get that one to fall. The Warriors go the other way with it. Their last meeting was in Boston, where they were unable to fight off the Celtics.
Last time they lost a close one against this team. You have to wonder what they could have done if it wasn't for their foul trouble in that game.
Getting into foul trouble will really handcuff you, and they found that out last time.
Horford for three. Connects from downtown. Horford's got his second bucket of the night.
Excellent perimeter offense so far. Their shooters are clearly in a great rhythm.
And the call will be against Derek White. That's his first foul of the game. And there are a lot of insane records in the NBA history books. Which do you think are the most unbreakable, RJ?
Well, I've got four off the top of my head. The 100 points by Wilt. I think LeBron James' playoff scoring record, because a player is going to have to go to like 13 finals. And they're going to have to average 25 points a game in order to pass that. And then A.C. Green, he's got almost 1,200 consecutive games played. That's 15 straight seasons.
And that Joe Stockton's assist record.
Yeah, no one's catching that, because he didn't miss many games either.
Thompson against White. Nice move. And again, it's Golden State.
We all know Klay can hit this. His accuracy from the mid-range is a reliable option, to say the least.
Here's Green. 11 points for him last game against Boston. Pass to Thompson. Curry with it. There's the triple. Sinks it from distance. Curry's got his third bucket of the night.
Defensively, you have to be aware of Curry in that set.
The baseline J. Oh, nice shot by Brown. And the Celtics lead by 11.
And from the mid-range area, they've been the more effective team.
Golden State calls timeout. Well, Grant, you look at the Celtics and their defense. Not a surprise, it's at the heart of this team.
No question. I mean, you have three-plus defenders on the perimeter. Their big men can switch on the guards and protect the rim, too. Top to bottom, they can match up well with any team.
Substitution here for Boston. Robert Williams checked in for Horford. Williams comes in for Jason Tatum. Brogdon's checked in for White. And Pritchard is subbed in for Smart. Poole. The pass to DiVincenzo. And it's good for two.
They keep trading punches. Both teams in a groove early. You have to think at this point the winner will be the one to settle in on defense.
And the jam by Brown. Boy, I like their energy coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Couldn't come up with a much better start than this. They just have to keep it going.
Now here's Poole. And you look at his numbers, just over 21 a game. Puts up a three. Another three for Golden State.
When he gets a quality look like this at the perimeter, he can almost be automatic.
Here's Brown. Oh, and a dunk by Brown.
Was it just me or was there a little bit extra on that slam by Brown?
And that replay courtesy of the AT&T 5G Slamcam. And the Warriors with possession here. It's a 10-point game. A tough loss coming against Boston in their last game.
It was poor efficiency scoring the ball. They needed too many attempts to get their points.
Yeah, it looked like they were settling out there, not moving the ball enough to generate the type of shots that they wanted.
Green finds Kuminga. Here is DiVincenzo. Iguodala outside. Pass to Kuminga. Over Williams.
Right now, they're losing ground. I mean, they might need to switch things up a bit. Maybe hit the offensive boards a little harder.
Warriors with the rebound. Poole outside. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
When we talk about guys who broke out during the 2021-22 season, Jordan Poole might be at the top of that list, going from a nice rotation player to a legit NBA scorer.
Talking about Jordan Poole, his confidence never wavered, Richard.
No, remember, Poole shot 33% his rookie season. Lots of people kind of wrote him off, but Jordan's always believed in his game. Took advantage of injuries to Clay and Steph, grabbing those extra shots.
The first free throw is good. Both free throws good for Poole.
Yeah, you know, after a couple down years with key players injured, it's safe to say the Golden State Warriors are back.
Here's Brown. And the jam by Brown.
Quick down the lane. Brown flying by defenders.
Pass to Green. To the middle. Hey, how's that for an answer? Right back with the dunk.
And one move ahead of the defense. A solid pick.
And then the monster dunk to complete the play. Well done.
Well, great chemistry on display. He understood where to put the screen in order to free up his teammate.
The Warriors are back to contending for championships.
Yes, they are. A testament to their perseverance and belief in themselves. They knew once they got healthy, they would be a threat. And they've been a fun team to watch as they get back to form.
Williams' shot is good.
No question who's in control of the board so far.
And here's Iguodala. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Green for three. Williams grabs the board.
That was a good possession. They got a clean look, but the shot just didn't fall.
Here's Brown. And the jam by Brown.
One of the premier scoring wings in the NBA. Jaylen Brown is at it again.
1:46 left to play in the first quarter. Poole against Brogdon. Here's Kuminga. Oh, it's blocked by Williams. And he's able to get it back. The kick out to Poole. Four on the clock. And that one's good.
Jordan.
And Green with the assist. Poole's got 8 points.
Nice ball movement there. That's how you break down the defense.
Here's Brogdon. And it's blocked. Boston scoring again.
It's impossible to win when you give up second and third chances to score.
DiVincenzo on the wing. The three-pointer off the mark. Boston's gone 3 for 5 from deep so far in this matchup. Here's Pritchard. No luck on that one. Good work defensively by DiVincenzo. Well, the Warriors shooting an excellent 56% in this quarter. Here's Green. And it's hammered home by Green.
Assisted.
Hey, kept it simple. No reason to get fancy right now, BA.
Yeah, he's just looking to find shots and produce for his team. Pritchard, no good.
That's the shot they wanted. It just didn't fall.
Tough to watch those miss. I'm sure they'll convert the next chance.
Out of bounds. It'll be Celtics ball. Griffin, he's checked in for Williams. Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. Fresh off a win against the Warriors.
Thanks to their stellar defensive intensity, they registered a ton of stops in that one.
They were hustling to get in front of every play they could, always getting a hand in the shooter's face.
It's Boston now. They've got a 9-point lead. Here's Pritchard. Good. And Brown gets the assist.
And they're behind right now because they're failing to play quality defense. It's that simple.
And the Warriors shooting a terrific 58% to start the game. Excellent numbers. Pass to Green. To the inside. And here's Iguodala. Defended by Brown. Poole with the ball. Inside. Kuminga, the pass to Iguodala. The three. The three, DiVincenzo. Rebound, Boston. Now Brown. Oh! And a dunk by Brown!
Muscling that one in. JB is a strong individual.
And here's Kuminga for three. And as we conclude the first quarter, a one-sided game so far. It's the Celtics. They lead by 13. And we'll bring you the start of quarter number two when we return. And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for the Celtics. And the Warriors' shooting has been good, 54% on this one. So on the floor for Golden State to kick off the second quarter. The core of the dynasty all on the floor. Curry and Clay, the guards, with Draymond up front at the four. Kevon Looney is out there with Andrew Wiggins.
They're really dictating the tempo on both ends of the court. You love it.
And guys, to go on a big run, get some breathing space, it has to be a great play on each end.
Tatum's gone 6 of 9 from the field. Curry against Smart. Down low. Oh, got a piece of it. Horford with a steal. Time now to hear from our reporter, Ali LaForce.
Thanks. Well, Jason Tatum added muscle to his frame and layers to his game, but still not satisfied. He said, quote, I just got to be better. I have to elevate my level from being one of the top 10 to 15 players to a top 5 player. I got to make everybody else around me better. Brian, still work to do.
And plenty of runway to do it, Ali. Thanks.
I'll tell you what, they've rebounded the ball tremendously well.
His first shot attempt. Looney grabs a miss. Looney's got 4 rebounds now. Outside, Green. Pass to Thompson. And that one's good. And Green with the assist. Thompson's got 11 points.
Nice start for him beyond the arc. He's already hit 3 triples, and I'm pretty sure there's more to come.
Horford. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up.
And it seemed wherever Horford has gone during his career, his teammates really enjoy playing with him. A testament to his leadership.
Line for 2 shots.
Shoot 2.
Knocks down the first one. You can tell Horford's teammates look up to him. He's an accomplished veteran with a lot of experience and knowledge, Richard.
Yeah, he's just so selfless. The kind of guy who actively tries to make his teammates better. Just a terrific glue guy.
It's both from the stripe.
You want to talk about a high-value veteran, Al Horford is your guy. I mean, he's been around the block and has a ton of wisdom to share with younger guys.
Curry gets the bucket.
Their defense has to do a better job of smothering those shooters.
Here's Smart. There's the drive. Good efficiency. He's drained 4 out of 5.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
Yeah, they got to do a much better job of putting a little bit of pressure on him on his way to the hoop.
Pass to Wiggins. Looney, a screen on Tatum. Let's it go from 11. Again, the Warriors score.
So polished from this painted area. Love watching Wiggins do his thing close to the basket.
Here's Griffin. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Looney's got his 5th rebound in this one. To the paint. No good there. Nice D from Tatum.
And he's usually able to score on that type of defense rather easily. Surprising to see him come away empty.
That one goes in. Tatum's got 17 points.
I love seeing Tatum exhibit the passion that he has shown us tonight. Such a motivated performance by him.
And here's Curry for 3. And that one goes. He's shooting 5 of 9 in this one.
They've been pretty lax with their perimeter defense, giving up a lot of 3-pointers.
Here's White. Again, Boston.
And very few teams rely on mid-range jumpers nowadays. But that's been their preferred way of finding points.
Smart against Curry. And here's Thompson for 3. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Curry. Curry's got 5 assists in the game.
They're getting torched on the perimeter. 4 of the last 5 buckets have been 3s.
Oh, got that one up quick. Smart's got 6 points in the quarter.
The offensive success is due in part to his quality shooting. He hasn't wasted too many looks.
Wiggins passes to Curry. No good with the triple. Boston's gone 3 of 5 from the perimeter in this game. Here's Horford. Banked it in off the glass. 9 points in the game.
Pure physical ability gives Horford the advantage. The defense couldn't hold him down.
Curry against Smart. This one for three. And Curry is good for three.
Man, they're having a hard time defending the triple. That's three in a row.
The Celtics have gotten seven of their first nine shots to drop during the second. Oh, wasted no time on that one. And the Celtics lead by 14.
You thought that first quarter was good? He's been even better in the second.
Curry against Smart. It's Wiggins on the wing. Horford with some nice D.
You have to credit their effort. I mean, they've done an amazing job on the glass.
Here's White. The putback controls the rebound and the putback.
I mean, they've been relentless. Just keep getting shots at the rim.
The Warriors have gotten six of their 12 attempts to go since the end of the first. Pass to Curry. From deep three-point range. The rebound, Celtics. Horford's got five rebounds tonight. And Horford powers it home.
Look at Horford just rocketing off the floor. Putting the defense on notice with a big dunk.
Now here's Looney, hounded by Tatum. To the inside. Oh, and a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
He just rises up and throws it down hard with one hand.
That is such a go-to move for him. He holds nothing back on those. Grant, so much young talent to the Warriors. Many said they should trade for veterans, but they resisted.
And they won a title anyways. I mean, with the salary cap perhaps their greatest obstacle, having contributors on cost-controlled rookie contracts sure helps.
Tatum with a steal. And they're going to count that bucket, and they'll send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
Okay, just some big boy strength there for Tatum. Just put himself to the line.
Hey, guys, talk about silencing the critics. Tatum made first-team All-NBA last year and led the Celtics to their first finals appearance in over a decade.
Williams has checked in for Griffin. And the Celtics call time here. You know, probably the biggest shift for Tatum, his advancement at the defensive end, Grant.
Oh, no question, B.A. And that's imperative at the small forward position. Think about it. You have guys like LeBron, Kawhi, KD. Now Jason Tatum is in that elite two-way group as well. And you have to put Jimmy Butler in there as well.
Western Conference standings now that the new year is upon us. You look at the Warriors, and so far they own the ninth best record in the conference. Not where they'd like to be.
Well, I think for Golden State, they're just not where they thought they'd be as a ball club. Now, after the success they had last season, they were counting on having even a better year.
And it's the exact opposite has happened. The chemistry has been off. They haven't been able to maintain momentum. A very disjointed season for them up until this point.
And that one falls for Tatum. Well, with roster sizes expanding and the addition of two-way contracts, the NBA has 100 more roster spots than around 12 years ago. RJ, how's that changed things in your mind?
Well, you just need so much more scouting and development. And you look at the different teams around this league, the ones that have continued success are the ones that are always able to find those diamonds in the rough. It's easy to get somebody good with a top five pick. Show me a team that can find somebody with a 30th or 35th pick. And man, is he in his zone right now. Seems like he can't miss.
Fires the three. And Curry is good for three. Curry's got 12 points now in the quarter.
He is lighting them up from range this period. This team has made a concerted effort to get him shots. I tell you, a little extra pressure on D when you're up against a point guard who can elevate,
it doesn't make it easy, does it?
Yeah, hard to strategize for a guy who can make a pass or a play like this right in your face.
Horford against Looney. And the Celtics, another three.
And he can still do so many things for you. Big Al calmly knocking it down from distance.
Knocks it loose. It's stolen by Smart. He goes up. Rips down the breakaway slam.
They're really in control on both ends of the floor right now. Forcing turnovers and finding easy points while the other guys struggle to keep up.
Golden State calls timeout.
Here they come, it's Celtics Entertainment.
Changes for Boston. Robert Williams checked in for Horford. Brown comes in for Jason Tatum. And Brogdon is subbed in for White. And a new group getting ready for the Warriors. Green's checked in for Looney. Kuminga comes in for Green. Poole, he's checked in for Wiggins. And it's DiVincenzo in for Curry. This Warriors squad is struggling. Poole outside. Pass to DiVincenzo. Now Poole. Outside Kuminga. Shot clock at six. Here's Thompson. Can they get it? Smart grabs the miss.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the three-point line.
Here's Brown. It's rebounded by Golden State.
No clue how he misfired on that shot. You don't see that from him very often.
Thompson. That one is off. Now the Celtics take it the other way. Here's Brown. Another one falls for Boston.
Very confident in that jump of his.
Now here's Poole. He had a 24-point outing in their last game against the Celtics in Boston. For three. Williams grabs the board. Williams has got his fourth rebound in this one. Lets it fly from 18. No good off the front rim.
Well, the defense didn't have any impact on that shot, but somehow he still misses it.
Outside for Green. For three. Hauled in by Brown. Boston has gone 4 of 6 from three-point range thus far. Shoots from the baseline and can't get it. He's now 1 of 3.
Really thought he had this one, and the defense, they were giving it to him.
Hook loose. Outside, Green. Outside, Kuminga. Left side, DiVincenzo. Knocks down the triple. DiVincenzo's got 5 points.
Defensively, gotta close out a little faster. That's a look he'll make with regularity.
Here's Brogdon. Boston, no good that time either. And the Warriors shooting a decent 41% in the second quarter. Pass to Thompson. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket is good, and he'll go to the line.
His shot has been on point from the opening tip. He's pretty much kept them in the game.
Klay Thompson, one shot.
Free throw is good from Thompson. And we think back to 2015, Grant. Klay Thompson with the best quarter in league history.
Oh, B.A. 37 points from him in one quarter, setting an NBA record. Klay 13 for 13 from the field and 9 for 9 from deep, taking only 4 dribbles the entire time. Only Klay Thompson, guys.
Poole from long range. Another 3 for Golden State.
They are shooting it well from beyond the arc right now.
From the wing, another one falls for Boston.
6 of their last 10 points have come from that mid-range area.
DiVincenzo, pass to Green. Over Williams. Tries yet again. And it's good on the lay-in.
That'll drive your coach crazy. Failing to box out.
Yeah, you think you gotta stop, and it's wasted because of sloppy work in the glass. You literally practice that every day.
Smart with the bucket.
He's just got it on automatic right now. Shooting 100%, and that'll keep your confidence high.
2 minutes remaining in the first half.
Brogdon against Poole. Green, the pass to Poole. The 3-ball. And he finishes. Jordan. That makes him 4 out of 5.
Yeah, he's in his bag from beyond the arc right now. You see his confidence.
And, of course, it helps space the floor, which gives this offense more room to operate.
And the shot goes. Brown's got 26.
And each year, it seems Brown keeps getting better at shooting the ball, especially from the mid-range.
DiVincenzo, pass to Green. Pass to Thompson. Poole against Brown. Thompson, a screen on Brown. Out to Thompson. DiVincenzo, pass to Thompson. Another 3 for Golden State.
Can't blame the deficit on him. He's been scoring at will this period.
Here's Williams. Offensive rebound.
He's so strong. He goes to work on the glass. One opening is all he'll need to finish the play, even if it's just a tip-in.
It's been a devastating night for them. Nothing has come easy, Grant.
Nothing indeed. Even when they've tried to make adjustments, it just hasn't worked.
Assisted by Klay Thompson.
Here's Brogdon. He has 6. The 3. Drills it from deep. Brogdon's got 7 points here in the quarter.
What control for Brogdon. The pull-up is so hard to master.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Malcolm Brogdon. That'll be a second foul of the game.
That's a second, and I think they'll keep him in. But he's got to be careful. A third, and he'll sit for the rest of the half.
The Celtics making a switch here. Pritchard's checked in. And Golden State also making a switch. Iguodala's checked in. DiVincenzo finds Iguodala. It's Poole on the wing. Iguodala with a screen on Brogdon. And he makes no mistake. Slam dunk.
Now that's how you use the screen right there.
And it leads to a thunderous finish. That was nice.
Yeah, you like the pick to set up the open shot. But when it leads to a double, okay, we'll take it.
And when the mid-range is open, Brogdon won't hesitate. He'll happily take those points off you.
3 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. To the middle. Here's Kuminga. And he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
Just a textbook lead pass right there, putting it right where it needed to be.
Baseline try. And there's Brogdon with the basket on the assist from Williams. Brogdon's got 13.
I really enjoy watching Malcolm Brogdon, one of the smarter players in the league, on and off the court.
Cool for three. It doesn't go for him. And so it's the Boston Celtics continuing to pile it on, up 22 as we head to the break. It hasn't taken them too many shots to get their points. They're winning with efficiency. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Here with Coach Steve Kerr, your defense struggling to contain them in the first half. How do you remedy it?
We got to get back in transition. We got to make them feel us. You know, they're just running anything they want. We've got to at least disrupt the stuff they're trying to do.
Thank you, Coach.
Thanks very much, Allie. We'll be back soon to start the second half of basketball.
And hello, everybody. What an amazing first half performance it's been for the Boston Celtics.
They've been money tonight. Matter of fact, they got the shmoney, Ernie. Get it? The shmoney.
No, great, I don't.
Great game, though. It's a great, great play. Shaq gets it.
But actually, I don't get it either.
Creating their offense and they're converting open shots.
Must be nice as a coach to sit back and watch what you drew up work to perfection.
It's not about the money, it's about the shmoney.
You know what rhymes with shmoney or money? Dummy.
All right, now let's check out what the fans are saying on social media. So here's one for Shaq from Dunkmaster J. Shaq, is it true you're the league's all-time MHP? I'm not even sure what that means. Any ideas?
Duh, Ernie. Ernie, it means most handsome player. And I am. That's true. In fact, that's a great question.
Wait a minute. How could you know that? Maybe it's the most hairless player or the most hungry player.
I got to back up Kenny on this one. It could be the most hilarious for all that we know. That seems more fitting to me.
Ha ha, very funny.
Thanks for tuning in. Now we head back to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter. With the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Jaylen Brown having a dominant impact in this game.
Yeah, they've done an amazing job of creating room to operate for him. And then, of course, executing.
I like how they came into this one with a game plan, and they're just going out and executing it. Terrific job.
Smart and White make up the backcourt. The core of this team, Brown and Tatum, they're the forwards.
And it's Horford in at the center position, filling out the middle. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. Just three to shoot. Here's Wiggins. Tatum pulls it in. Tatum's got his eighth rebound here tonight.
And they're up considerably because of their efforts on the glass.
And the Boston Celtics are one of the most decorated teams in all of sports. Think about all the rings they've won, as well as the talent that they've had on their roster.
And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Well, guys, the Celtics are handing the keys to the two Jays, Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown. There have been growing pains and even some question if the pair could coexist. But Brown said, quote, "The adversity will help us grow. As long as I'm on the same page with him and he's on the same page with me, we're all good." Brian?
Figuring it out, Allie. Thank you. 2 points. That one goes. Horford's got 16 points.
Oh, nothing new for Horford. He knows how to score against tough coverage.
Curry passes to Looney. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Curry. Curry's got his seventh assist of the game with that last one. The Celtics have gone just 1 of 3 in the second half. Such a rich history for the respected Boston franchise.
From the days of Bill Russell to Larry Bird and Kevin McHale in the 80s, and then Pierce Allen, KG Rondo winning the ring in 08, the players on this roster understand how important it is to carry on that legacy.
Curry gets the bucket.
And this has been a nice start to the second half. They're 3 out of 4 in the rhythm on the offense right now.
Here's Tatum. Again, the Celtics good for 2 more.
The defense must be aware of where Tatum is, especially when he's roaming around that mid-range.
Wiggins right side from the arc. Another 3 for Golden State.
On fire to start the second half. 4-5 from the field.
Boston has gone 6 of 9 from 3-point range. Tatum. That one goes. Count it. Tatum's got 4 points this quarter.
And just not letting up at all. I mean, you have to love this approach. You want to get the ball to the guys who make plays.
This is when good players really get after it. He can sense that they're reeling, and he's going to put his foot on the pedal.
For Boston, they've gotten 4 of 7 shots to drop in the third. Baseline jumper. Again, the Celtics good for 2 more.
His accuracy is on another level this quarter. Really high-quality shooting.
Pass to Looney. Now here's Curry. 3-pointer. Rebound Boston. Brown's got 4 rebounds in the game. Horford outside. The kick to Tatum. Back to Horford. From the high post. And Tatum with the basket. On the assist by Horford. Tatum's got 30.
Oh, man. They have really heated up for good range.
Outside Curry. Three-pointer. Rebounded by the Celtics. Horford's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. And again, it's Jason Tatum. Tatum's got 32 points in the game.
He's been dominant all game long. Nobody on the floor can stop him. And look, let's just say he knows it.
It's stolen by Smart. Driving to the basket, and a foul called on the way up. So he'll take 2 from the free throw line. It's on Stephen Curry.
The officials were right on top of that one.
Marcus Smart is one of the toughest players in this league, mentally and physically. So willing to sacrifice himself on a play, on both ends.
Falls for him. Smart's toughness does really stand out on defense, though, Richard.
Yeah, because he gets right up in your jersey. Even though it can put him in harm's way, if he thinks he can trip you up at all, he'll put his body on the line.
Griffin, he's checked in for Boston. And so Smart nails them both. RJ, you're in the middle of a few trades in your career, to put it lightly.
What's that like as a player to get moved around so much?
Thanks for bringing that up so sweetly, Brian. I appreciate that. Look, there's pros and cons to this. It's nice to know that another organization wants you for whatever reason, but it's also tough to leave an organization that you had a connection to, the fan base. But eventually, you figure it out.
Of the last month, here are the NBA's best free throw shooting teams. In the third spot, the Celtics.
And looking at last month, this team really got it done from the charity stripe. Whenever you foul them, they made sure to make you pay for that mistake.
Just over 3.5 minutes through the third. Smart against Curry to end the run. Knocks it down from distance. Curry's got 25 points.
This defense just can't stay connected to shooters.
Pass to Horford. Over Looney. Again, the miss by the Celtics. Golden State has gone 3 of 5 from downtown here in the second half. Thompson against White from behind the arc. Another three for Golden State.
A dozen consecutive points off of threes. This defense looks rattled.
Horford with it. Looney grabs a miss. Wiggins outside. Curry passes to Looney. Ooh, rejected by Horford.
The great positioning, the 7-1 wingspan. That combination makes Horford a dangerous shot blocker.
Klay Thompson pulls down the board.
That is a rarity. When he takes flight, he usually hammers it home. When you let a team knock down that many threes, you know you're likely to be on the wrong side of a run.
For Boston, they've gone 7 of 13 in the second half. Here's Smart. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line. Kevon Looney picks one up.
Man, good whistle there.
Second team ball.
And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for the Celtics.
Marcus Smart at the line for two.
And he drops a first. Poole, he's checked in for the Warriors. And he makes both free throws.
And really strong at the line since the break.
The Warriors shooting it with confidence. 54% so far. Pass to Wiggins. Green with a screen on Tatum. Wiggins passes to Green. Outside Curry. There's the three. Connects again from distance. Buries his 10th triple of the game.
Unbelievable, B.A. Unbelievable.
Here's Tatum. Ooh, cans the tough leaner from the outside. Tatum's got 12 points in just the second half.
He's been a piece of the puzzle tonight, but it's a team effort. Everyone's contributing to this lead.
Poole finds Curry, launches it, and the Warriors with another three.
For his sake, I hope they can come back. You hate to see the performance he's having be wasted in a loss.
Here's White. Warriors with the rebound.
He made that way more difficult than it had to be with that leaning jumper. As a result, he comes away empty. So much to say about Draymond's game. Tough to say anyone else in the league has a larger impact on their team on both sides of the floor.
And Richard, the weight that Draymond carries for this team can't be forgotten.
The impact he has on the defense alone is remarkable. But then you factor in the offense ability, bringing the ball up the floor. There is no doubt he is the vocal leader and the heartbeat.
Two shots.
Throw good, Green, and watching Draymond Green play. Grant, he's the quarterback on both ends.
I love that, B.A. Defensively, constantly calling out instructions on how to switch, keeping everyone organized. And offensively, Green is an incredible passer, sees guys get open before they do.
Robert Williams checked in for Boston. Brogdon comes in for White. Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
For something entertainment.
Taking a broader look here at the year-over-year scoring trend for Malcolm Brogdon.
And when you look at his offensive output over the past few years, it seems like other teams have figured him out and have his number now. He's having to put in a lot more effort on the offensive end, but without producing nearly the same results.
Both free throws good for Green.
A vocal leader both on and off the floor. Green plays with a real fire in edge.
Here's Tatum. Count the basket. Tatum's got 14 points here in the second half.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Kuminga with a screen on Brogdon. Poole from long range. No good that time. And it's Boston the other way. Bounds. The Warriors will take it. And that shot was going nowhere thanks to that aggressive swat.
Oh, amazing indeed. And getting stops like that only encourages them to keep attacking on the offensive end.
Smart against Curry. Wiggins for three, and that one's good. And Green with the assist. Wiggins has got 12 points in the game.
This is what it's been since halftime. Remarkable results from downtown.
In the modern NBA, you have to hit threes to win games, and they've made that adjustment since the break.
Outside Curry. No good from outside. Boston has gone 6 of 9 from three-point range. The outside leaner. Again, the Celtics good for two more. And the Warriors shooting nearly 60% from the floor in the third. Green against Williams. Wiggins right side. Green, the pass to Kuminga. And he banks in the layup. Give him eight.
As team first as anyone in this league, Green is always looking to dish.
They are blowing this one open.
Maybe the only question is how big will this lead grow?
They get the rebound. Williams' shot is good.
And that's a backbreaker for the defense. I mean, offensive boards like that run momentum against you.
And you can see them just deflate after giving up that score. And they know that they can't dig themselves out of this hole if they're allowing second chance points.
And here are the Warriors now. After the basket by Boston. Wiggins passes to Green. Shot clock at five. Blocked!
Griffin still possessing such incredible timing. Shooters have to be careful when he's on the prowl.
And the Warriors make some changes. Green comes in for Green. And Iguodala subbed in for Wiggins. It's the Warriors with the ball. They trail by 18. Poole shot is off.
Would you say testing the limits of his range there?
Yeah, he might have been feeling himself a little too much on that one. He can hit it, but not consistent.
And for the Warriors, their shooting has been good. 54% on this one. Inside. Tatum with the block.
The all-star Tatum engaged on defense. That's a scary sight for opponents.
Over Curry. A nice shot by Tatum. Tatum's got 38 points.
Just continuing to pile it on, refusing to let up.
If he has space in the mid-range, he'll let it fly. Doesn't matter if the score is tied or they are up big.
Sinks the tray.
Just an unselfish play from Curry, always ready to move the ball and his body to help an open shooter.
And Griffin gets it to go. Here's Curry. 37 points for him. From deep. Williams grabs the board. Williams has got his eighth rebound here tonight. Fires the three. Drains the triple. Williams has got 5 points now in the quarter.
They're making it look easy out there, just having fun.
Man, their offense is clicking. Players, coaches, everybody, they are in sync.
And Marcus Smart picks up the foul. That's his first foul of the game. Some changes for Boston. Williams comes in for Griffin. And Pritchard is subbed in for Smart. Draymond Green, he's checked in for the Warriors. DiVincenzo comes in for Curry. Kuminga, the pass to Iguodala. Now DiVincenzo jacks up a three. Rebounded by Brogdon.
And the defense dodged one right there. Not the guy you want to leave open.
Tatum. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. They'll take on the Cavaliers at Rocket Mortgage Fieldhouse after this one. It's the last leg of what's been a daunting road trip. Six games in total.
He just can't find a consistent way to score. And this team could certainly use it.
Launches a three. Nails it from three. Tatum's got 41.
He's been the guy tonight. Really impressive performance.
Pass to Green. To the middle. Here's DiVincenzo. And that comes off the assist by Green.
It's interesting. They definitely had more three-point attempts in the first half. Not sure why they went away from it.
They get it back. Good. 5 for 9 shooting so far.
They haven't been able to grab many rebounds, getting burned on second chance opportunities.
Poole against Brogdon. Outside, DiVincenzo. Iguodala with a screen on Brogdon. The drive by Poole. And a two-handed jam.
Now that's how you use the screen right there.
And it leads to a thunderous finish. That was nice.
Yeah, you like the pick to set up the open shot. But when it leads to a dunk, okay, even better, we'll take it.
Now here's Williams. When the whistle blows, it's going to be on Jonathan Kuminga. That's his first foul of the game. The Celtics making a switch here. Brown's checked in.
Coming onto the floor for the Celtics, Jaylen Brown.
Tatum from converting.
Well, the Warriors shooting around 52% since the start of third. Kuminga with a screen on Brown. Iguodala outside. Here's Kuminga. Oh, what a finish in traffic! My goodness! 54 seconds left in the third. Wing shot on the way. And it's good as he snuts it right through the net.
Proving he's more than just a go-to scorer. Brown also loves swinging the ball to open teammates.
Iguodala, the pass to Green. And there's another one for the Warriors.
They have no answer defensively inside.
Boston's gone 2 for 5 from three since halftime. And Pritchard, here we go. Good work defensively by DiVincenzo. Well, the Warriors' shooting has been good. 54% on this one. There's 25 seconds left in the third quarter. From deep three-point range, Williams grabs the board. The Celtics' shooting has been spectacular. 67%. Just incredible. The steal. Going all the way to the rack. Here's DiVincenzo. Good work defensively by Brogdon. Here's Tatum. It's good! It's good at the buzzer! Wow!
Makes his selection just in time. Well done.
He didn't even look worried about the time on the clock. Nice way to end a quarter.
All right, let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
Ooh, I'm fired up to see this dish one more time. It's always great to see your two guards share the wealth.
Not just playing selflessly, but also making a smart decision with the ball.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today. As we get going in quarter number four, on the floor for the Warriors, we've got Andre Iguodala, Dante DiVincenzo out there with Moody, then it's Jermichael Green.
Not all his mid-range jumpers are created equal. That's one they'll take all night long.
Here's Iguodala, after the basket by Boston, pass to Baldwin. Outside, DiVincenzo. And for players, greatness can be defined so many ways, but giving back has to be a component of that. Wouldn't you say, Grant?
Well, to whom much is given, much is expected. In BA, I agree 100%. Players today understand the impact that they can have on others. I love that about the league, the players, the coaches, everyone involved, using this gift to make a change and a positive impact throughout the world.
Brown with the block.
Terrific anticipation by Brown, managing to see the shot coming and get ahead of it.
Griffin, he's checked in for Boston. White comes in for Brown. Green for three. And again, it's the Warriors missing. And Boston has possession. Lets it go from 11. White, good.
Strong pass there to set up the basket.
Golden State has gone 0 for 3 here in the fourth. Pass to Green. Here's Baldwin. Fires from deep. And that one's good. And Green with the assist.
3 points.
Green's got four assists now tonight.
You can't lose a shooter like him on the court. The ball will find its way to him, and he will drill a three each time.
And the shot goes in.
Didn't really need to put himself off balance like that, but hey, he'll take it.
Golden State has gone only 1-4 from the perimeter here in this fourth quarter. To the inside, Iguodala, and they get it back. Shoots over Jackson. Can't get it to drop. And Boston going the other way now.
Just an ugly show from him offensively. Yep, no way to describe it. Just ugly, and that hasn't helped.
Pulled the shot a little left. The bounce goes his way, though.
Nice ball movement there. Delivered the pass right on time.
The Warriors have got 1 out of 6 shots to fall in this final quarter. Not ideal. Here's Iguodala, and he goes in for the dunk.
Just magnificent. I mean, he punishes the D for lackluster effort.
They look a little disorganized there, but the result is an emphatic jam.
Yeah, when you're not locked in on defense, they will make you pay with an easy finish there.
Here's Moody. Pass to Green from deep. Griffin pulls down the board. Griffin's got 5 rebounds in the game. Here's Jackson. Got a hand on it. Just over 2.5 minutes played now. Final quarter of regulation. Here's Iguodala. And they recover it. Here's the floater. And he lays it in.
The floater is so tough to defend against. Nothing defenders can really do but shake their heads.
The Celtics have gotten 5 of their 7 shots to fall in this final quarter. Iguodala with the rebound.
Look, I'll give him an A for effort for trying to dunk through the defense, but maybe he should ease up on that one just a little bit.
Here's Pritchard. Pass to Cornett. And he gets the bucket. Cornette's gotten his first basket of the night.
Rate of baskets assisted, it's a stat I really like. It tells the story of how well you are playing team offense.
Here is DiVincenzo. Green for 3. The rebound by Jackson.
His consistency just hasn't been there this quarter in terms of his shooting.
Here's White. Here's Griffin. Warriors with the rebound. DiVincenzo's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
And they're up right now, but it hasn't been because of him. He's really struggled on offense.
Here's Baldwin. And again, it's the Warriors missing. The Celtics have gone 6-for-11 here in the fourth quarter. And here's Griffin outside. And he can't get that one.
Well, he better buy his teammates dinner tonight because they've covered him for what has been a terrible, absolute terrible shooting display.
Iguodala finds DiVincenzo. Rebounded by the Celtics. Richard's got 4 rebounds now.
Yeah, no triples for him here in the second half. One fell in the first, though. Can he turn it up?
Jackson can't get it to go.
There's no way that's the best look this offense can produce.
And you couldn't get a better shot off? Like, come on, you got to make the extra pass. Like, being a teammate will go so far in this league.
Pass to DiVincenzo. Down low. Here's Moody. Beyond the arc. Iguodala outside. Nails it from beyond the arc. Iguodala's got 7 points here in the quarter.
When he has enough space, he's more than comfortable letting it fly from outside.
And the Celtics call time here.
Please give a big round of applause for your Celtics youth next team. Fans, your Celtics, you Nancy.
And now let's present our New Balance Player of the Game, Jason Tatum.
This has been one of the most dominant performances I've ever seen. What's incredible is he has no off switch, just a tremendous motor, and he's making an impact on every single possession. And look at him. You think it's just another game. He is totally in control of his emotions.
Oh, man, what an effort tonight. To put together this type of game against the defending champs, that is impressive. This is why so many people hold him in such high regard. The Celtics have gotten 6 of their 13 shots to go. White finds Griffin. Over Green. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it. It's good.
At this stage in his career, Griffin brings with him a deep arsenal of moves inside.
Pass to Green. Lets the three fly. And the Warriors get it back. DiVincenzo on the wing. Offline with a three.
I think he's gone completely dry. Nothing is hitting.
Yeah, and the risk now is that he gets inside his own head. Time to take deep breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth, and let the game come to you. You know, some people could say he's struggling on offense this period. I like to think of more of drowning. Just can't seem to find his confidence. He gives up a bit of size at the center position, but his leaping ability, well, let's just say that makes up for it.
To the paint. Here's Griffin. It's rebounded by Golden State. Outside, DiVincenzo. And it's hammered home by Green.
He put a little flair on that one.
Yes, he did. Man, he's a strong finisher, huh? And Boston calls time here.
Here we go, fans. Time to make some noise for some teachers.
The Celtics have gotten 7 of 16 attempts to drop since the start of the fourth. White, it's good. Only a few seconds into the shot clock. White's gotten 4 this quarter. Well, the Warriors shooting around 30% since the fourth quarter got underway. Well, since Commissioner Silver took over, granted, it seems the league's dress code is now leaving more, let's say, wiggle room. You good with that?
Yeah, a lot of wiggle room, at least compared to when I played, when it was more of a business casual environment. But I think it's great. Let the players be themselves. Let them be authentic. And I think in a weird kind of way, it endears these players to the fans at home watching on TV.
Like a bunch of runway models before and after every game.
No question, no question.
So it's the Warriors now. Iguodala outside. Williams with it. And Looney picks him up defensively. Tries it from 16. They get it back. And there's two. Work on the glass. Pan off that time. Williams has got 9 points now in the second half. Well, the Warriors shooting at a 48% clip from the floor. Iguodala with the ball.
Boston foul. Justin Jackson.
And the Warriors making a change here. Kuminga's checked in.
Second team foul. Substitution for the Warriors. Jonathan Kuminga.
Looney passes to Iguodala. Here's Looney. 5 on the clock. Out to DiVincenzo. Let's go with a 3. Pure from 3-point range.
This has been their game plan here in the final period. We'll see if it continues to work out.
I think when you've got it going from 3-point range, you've got to keep it going. It's a good way to kind of pile up the points quickly.
Jackson's gone, just 1 of 5 from the floor. DiVincenzo finds Iguodala. Now here's Looney. Right side, DiVincenzo. Well, we've seen coaches' challenges introduced to the NBA. I think they've been great. What's your take, RJ?
Well, the league does a really good job of working with the replay center in the Secaucus, but there's one tweak. If you win your challenge, I feel like you should get a second. That's just in my opinion.
Yeah, I agree 100%.
In the second half, we've seen him refocus his shooting. Much fewer wasted possessions.
DiVincenzo can't hit.
And as long as he keeps missing from deep, the D will keep letting him fire away. He's just off from range right now.
Here's Griffin. Here's Williams. No good. A bit long that time.
That is not a bad decision to pull it from there. It was just a little bit off with the execution.
Here's Kuminga. Oh, a beautiful reverse layup.
Oh, just an easy reverse for him. He has nice feel and touch around the bucket.
Fires it. Griffin in the post. He's watched by Kuminga. They shoot again. And it's Williams with the bucket inside. Williams has got 4 points this quarter.
Well, after an uneven first half, he's managed to right the ship and get things going.
Now DiVincenzo. Iguodala outside. Here's Looney. Second shot opportunity. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up.
Well, that was clearly a foul.
At the line for the Warriors, Kevon Looney. At the line for two.
And he makes a first. Well, the NBA has gotten tougher on flagrant fouls. But you see instances where guys get hurt. They miss a lot of time, and yet there's only a 1-game penalty for the fouler. Something to look at, you think, RJ, or no?
Well, if the flagrant results in games missed due to injury, then maybe the fouler should miss more games. The only problem with that is you can see players starting to embellish on their injury in order to make sure that other people get suspended. That's how petty our league is.
And he'll take a trip to the line for two. Clearly got fouled on that shot.
Well, you have to be impressed with the constant growth we're seeing from Jaylen Brown. He's putting a lot of work to become an all-star player.
Free throw good, Brown. And at this point for Brown, do you think he's realized his full potential, Richard?
No, I don't even think so, especially when you look at his work ethic. He puts in so much time that I think he can reach another level. He's still young and eager to learn. If I were to put it in 2K terms, I think he could get up to about a 94, 95 overall.
And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
And we've watched Brown blossom into a talented scorer, someone who's capable of shouldering that entire offensive load.
Back to Iguodala. Takes a three. Williams grabs the board. Williams has got a rebound number five here tonight. Shoots over Kuminga. Kick out to Brown. Over Thompson. Pass to Brown. Shoots over Thompson. Brown can't hit. The Warriors shooting around 30% since the fourth quarter got underway. Brockton against Iguodala. To the middle. Here's Thompson. Oh, that's his eighth make of the game. He's only missed four so far.
We have seen Klay Thompson with some of the most impressive shooting performances in NBA history. His team and him both know you better feed that hot hand because he's got it going on.
They grab their own miss. Outside for Brogdon. From deep. And it goes out of bounds. That one off Brogdon. Iguodala against Brown. Here's Thompson. Again, Golden State.
And he's coming off a huge performance, and his confidence couldn't be any higher. And his coach knows that, too.
When it ain't broke, leave it alone. Until someone stops him, just let him roll.
The Warriors shooting about 48% from the floor. Pretty good. Here's Kuminga. Oh, and there's a one-hand jam.
It's safe to say they have dominated this game. The game wasn't even as close as the score says in a great win for the Celtics.
Pretty clear who the better team was today. They dominated in just about every phase of this game, Grant.
B.A., it's almost hard to think what didn't go well for them. Their plan, their execution, everything was absolutely on point.
And for the year now, they've chalked up 35 wins.
A big-time bragging rights won today, just grabbing that season series.
And as it was happening, as it was building, you knew this was a monster game for Jason Tatum.
And he was getting buckets all night long, giving the defense that work.
Now here's Iguodala. And the basket is good.
Andre Iguodala.
And Boston calls time here.
It's time for some t-shirts. Make some noise, man. Here we go, fans. Time to make some noise for Boston's own Celtics Entertainment.
There's 45 seconds left to play in the fourth. And here's Brown for three. Warriors with the rebound. Now here's Thompson. And he lobs it up top. Up high and down it goes on the lob.
The team first mentality of Thompson. When someone on his squad is open, he finds them.
Here's Pritchard. Kept alive. Here's Williams. Can't cash it in from the high post. Thompson passes to DiVincenzo. Here's Looney. Back to Iguodala. Good setup. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup.
These are exactly the kind of shots they want to generate each and every time down the floor.
Outside Brogdon. So we see the Celtics taking the W here. We saw two different teams tonight. One played with confidence, operating flawlessly. The other just lost.
And the energy in this building was awesome. The crowd was involved from the jump. Once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see how it all came together.
All right, now let's check in with Allie LaForce. Allie, what do you have?
Thank you very much. Jalen, you had it going. Can you talk about the confidence you had tonight?
I'm just trying to continue to show people what I can do, continue to get better. It's a long journey. It's a process. I still got a long way to go and a lot to learn, so I'm going to just keep going up.
It's all part of the journey. Thanks, Jalen.
All right, Allie, thank you. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. This is Brian Anderson saying thank you for tuning in. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.